Hi friends, in this video we are going to see some of the properties of ROC of the Z transform. The first property, the ROC consists of a ring in the Z plane centered about the origin. That means any function x of z is nothing but a z transform of x of n. We will get one function x of z, and the values of z for which the x of z is a finite, which is called as ROC, is consist of a circular lines, or you can say a circles whose center is origin always. So ROC consists of lines like this. Most importantly, it is centered about the origin. So a ring centered about the origin is nothing but a region of convergence for Z transform, which is nothing but those values of Z for which the x of Z is finite. Let's go to the next property. Property number 2. The ROC does not contain any pole, which is quite obvious. But to illustrate this, we will take a simple example x of z as z square upon z minus 1, z minus 2. It is a z transform of any random function x of n, but in the end we got this function x of z, and we need to find out those values of z for which this particular x of z exists finitely. So as we discussed in the property number 1, it will consist of a circular lines, or you can say circle centered about the origin, except two values. Rather three values. So x of z is finite except z equal to infinity, because if I have a z equal to infinity, this tends to infinity, z minus 1 equal to 0, because 0 in the denominator will give you infinite answer. So z minus 1 should not be equal to 0, rather I can say x of z is finite except z equal to 1, and z minus 2, if I have this also equal to 0, so once again x of z will be infinite if I have z equal to 2. So if you see carefully, z equal to 1 and z equal to 2 are nothing but location of the poles of x of z. Hence this example illustrates that the region of convergence does not contain any pole. Beside the location of poles, everywhere x of z exists finite. Third property. If x of n is a right-sided signal, then the ROC is the region in the Z plane outside the outermost pole. That is, it is outside the circle of radius equal to the largest magnitude of the pole. Of x of z. So once again, let's consider example x of z as z square upon z plus 1, z plus 2, and you have to get a inverse z transform this so that we'll get x of n. So thing is that just by looking at x of z and pole zero location of this, we can predict what type of signal this will be, either a left sided or a right sided. So what the property is saying, suppose we plot this pole and zero with a region of convergence. Here there are two circles we will get, one with a radius equal to 1 and another radius equal to 2. So this is a circle with the mod z equal to 1 and this is a circle with mod z equal to 2. Now based on the location of poles and zeros and what type of signal we want, rather here we are seeing a right sided signal, how to identify if the ROC is outside the outermost pole. So outermost pole over here, so this is z equal to 2. So outside pole is z equal to 2. So we can have the ROC outside the outermost pole. So this will be the ROC. It should consist of a circular lines, but to show properly, it is outside the z plus 2 equal to 0, that is mod z equal to 2, we are having this particular region which we say outside the outermost circle. So if this kind of ROC is there, then definitely the signal will be right sided. So even if there is one circle present, but the radius of that circle is less than this, hence the ROC will be outside the outermost circle, the signal will be right sided, or we can say the signal is a causal signal. Means in the x of n, we'll have the term u of n. So to determine whether it's a right sided, left sided signal or a both sided signal, this particular property is very important. So once again, a right sided signal, the ROC is outside the outermost pole. Let's check for left sided signal. Property number 4. It says if x of n is a left sided signal, then the ROC is the region in the z plane which is inside innermost pole. In other words, that is inside the circle of radius equal to the smallest magnitude of the pole of x of z. So once again, same example, x of z, if it is z square upon z plus 1, z plus 2. So if we plot a pole 0 with ROC, we will have two circles. This is corresponding to mod z equal to 1, and this is corresponding to mod z equal to 2. Remember, x of n will have the same value if you take an inverse z transform, but the ROC is the key feature which will tell what kind of a signal we will get. Now we want a left sided signal. So ROC will be inside the innermost pole. Innermost pole is corresponding to mod z equal to 1. So we will get ROC like this. Why? Because it's a left sided signal. So we can say for a left sided signal, the ROC is inside the innermost pole, and the left side signal is also called as non-causal signal. How to distinguish a left side and right side signal? Non-causal or left side signal will have u of minus n minus 1 in its expression, then we can say it's a left sided signal. So for a left sided signal, the ROC is inside the innermost pole. Let's go to property number 5. If x of n is a both sided signal, then ROC is the annular region, or you can say a ring-like region between two circles. And I'm assuming over here the two poles are there in x of z. So example is that x of z, z square upon z plus 1, z plus 2, and pole 0 plot with ROC something like this. Two circles, mod z equal to 2, here mod z equal to 1. To both sided signal will have a region between these two circles. Okay. So for a both sided signal, we will get a ROC between two circles. So I can write here, if you could see this type of a ROC, then you can directly say it's a both sided signal. And for a both sided signal, we will have u of n and u of minus n minus 1 terms present in the expression of x of n. Let's go to the last property of ROC. Let's go to the last property. What if the signal is a finite? So if x of n is of finite duration, then the ROC is the entire Z plane except possibly Z equal to 0 and or Z equal to infinite. A simple example we will take. Suppose X of n is with a sequence 1, 2, minus 1, 3, 4, like this, a finite duration. And let's consider the origin over here. So it's quite obvious that n is 0, here n is 1, n is 2, n is minus 1, n is minus 2. So why it is a finite? Because it has a definite start and definite end. Then x of z, as per the definition, will be summation n from minus infinity to infinity x of n z raised to minus n. And if I solve this, we'll get 1 into z square plus 2 into z minus 1 into z raised to 0 plus 3 into z raised to minus 1 plus 4 into z raised to minus 2. So in the end, I will get x of z as z square plus 2z minus 1 plus 3 by z plus 4 by z square. Now this x of z will have the finite value except two values of z, and those values are z equal to infinity and z equal to 0. Because if I have z equal to infinity, these two terms will become infinite. And if I have z equal to 0, these two terms will become infinite. So any value of z will do or will make this finite except z equal to infinity and z equal to 0. That is the meaning of this property. For finite duration, it is the entire z plane. Any value of z except z equal to 0 and or z equal to infinity. So here we have seen properties of ROC of Z transform.